Let's go ahead and create our first instance. That's where the most of the action is. Create instance, start accessing that instance, and that's when you will know how these things connect with each other. Okay. Compute instance, and right here, create instance. Give the name of the instance. I will say Sandusa INS instance 1. That would be too big. So let's make it smaller. Let's say San INS 1. And as I was talking about, there are three availability domains. If you have worked on the data center, you can consider this is the segregation within the data center. Like, so by default, we are going to go and use first availability domains. Next thing, you have to select image. Image is a very interesting thing. If you click on that, there are certain images by default available for you. You can directly select, for example, Oracle Linux 7.6, and Oracle, the OCI has a Oracle Linux installed image with all its library. So it makes very easy for you to just get a operating system with all its libraries available. I am a big fan of Oracle Linux. I am going to use Oracle Linux 6.1.0. Over here, it will ask you whether you are going for virtual machine or bare metal machine. Let's pick virtual machine, and then you see there is an opportunity for you to select the shape of that virtual machine. This is a trial version, the trial login. So I have a very limited options available, but in the real world, in your real project, when you buy enterprise access to OCI, you will see various options, and the combination of OCPU and memory is defines your shape of your instance, and that defines a lot of things like speed, bandwidth, and all other things. I'm going to select the maximum I have available here, that is OCPU 2 and 30 GB memory. Let's go for that. And mind you, your pricing, the price you're going to pay to Oracle is also depending on this, the kind of OCPU you use. As far as the compute goes, the pricing is based on how many OCPUs you are using per hour. So let's select that. By default, when the instance is created, it only assigns 46.6 GB of boot volume. If you want to assign more, you need to click here custom, and you need to put your volume you want. So I want, let's say 3000 GB. That should be enough. And this is very important. The access to OCI instance is through SSH keys. If you are a DBA, for example, and you want to access your Oracle database installed on Oracle Cloud, you can access that Unix box only through keys, the SSH key. And if you have gone through my other lecture where we have created SSH keys, you will have the key already available, and you're going to use that key over here. You just choose the SSH key. You can click on choose file and select that SSH key, or you can paste your SSH key here. So let's go ahead and select the public key. And you will see the name of the public key which you selected here. SSH, this is the public key name. And if you see that, that's fine. It is working. VCN details is already here based on what you have selected, like the compartment, virtual cloud network, and all other things. The subnet is based on the availability domain, and click on create. It will start provisioning the instance right here. Wait for the instance to be provisioned. It will be very fast, and then after that you can start using your instance. Awesome, the instance is ready and running. When you look at your instance, it will have the availability domain under which you have created. It will have OCID. As we discussed, each object, everything on OCI Oracle Cloud Infrastructure has its own unique OCID. It has image we used while creating the instance. And most important, it has two IP addresses, the private IP address and public IP address. The private IP address is what you can directly use if you have created IPsec tunnel. This is like a IP address you can use under a LAN which connects through IPsec tunnel to OCI. If you are connecting directly through public internet, you can use public IP address. There is FQDN, and as I mentioned, anything created in this virtual cloud network will have domain name appended as San Rusa, the virtual cloud network.oraclevcn.com, and for this instance the complete FQDN number name is this. Very good. It has subnet, what we saw. Next one to see is boot volume. And this is very interesting concept. The boot volume here, it is by default 6 GB boot volume assigned to it. So when the instance comes, it has only 46.6 GB boot volume assigned to this instance. How do you assign more space to this instance? That's the very interesting part we will see in next lecture. So very good, your instance is created. From next lecture onwards, we will get into this instance. We will access the instance through PuTTY and we will play around in this instance.